All right, guys, this is Doug Stocks. I'm going to remove this faucet from my big dog, and I'm going to replace it with this faucet right here. Ta-da! Okay. It's real simple to do this. I'm going to do it probably in two little short videos, only because I got to lay the phone down. But all you got to do is take a razor like this. I use a utility knife, any kind of razor, and score around the your sinks on your big dog. This is actually a big dog. I got three sinks on it. One, two, three. Some come with four. And all you got to do is score around them. Same principle. And you just take the blade and you just flip it under there and you score, and that'll break. All it is caulking hole in them. Okay? If you have to do anything underneath your cart, the easiest way is to take that sink out. And then you lift this up just like that, and you'll have hoses that are connected here and here. When you put it back together, you got to make sure that you put them hoses back on, and that those hoses go down in your gray water tank. That's where they go to, right there. All right? And here's your sink connection right here. All right? And all you have to do is disconnect this line and disconnect this line right here and here. That's your hot water and your cold water. And there's some little nut things that look like that right there that's holding this faucet in. Okay, and you unscrew those are threaded, and then you put your other faucet back on. Then you screw those back in, then you put your water lines back in. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and swap this out, and I'm gonna cut the video out for a minute. But that's how simple it is to work on these hot dog carts. You don't have to be a genius. You don't have to, you know, have a whole lot of money or anything like that. I think The replacement faucet on hotdogcartstore.com is like $20. It's not expensive at all. And if you're a Vendors United member and a Mafia member, you get it even cheaper. But that's how you see the, that's how get, water lines. This is the hot water. This is the cold water line. It's got a 3/4 inch. Nut on the end of it, but you can just use a crescent wrench to loosen it up about that wide. Anyway, that's a regular old crescent wrench like you got laying around the house, and you take those out, and then underneath that holds it down are these screws. They're, you normally just hand tight, and you just unscrew them. Remember, for the people that aren't mechanically inclined, lefty loosey and righty tighty. That's how, always remember that. Unless you're dealing with gas, you know, that's normally right. Lefty loosey, righty tighty. Y'all just heard something I hadn't heard, thought about in 100 years. Anyway, and then you just pull the old unit off and clean up underneath it. Make sure you get all the clean stuff up under it and wipe it off and everything. Make it all pretty. And then you take your other one, which I got here, which I've already got the, I got to take these nuts off. And then it just sits right back down, just like the old one did, just like that. And then you just take and screw these in. Always make sure you screw these in first, then put your water lines on. Okay, because what that does, that actually secures the faucet. And that just screws on just like I'm doing right there. But that's how simple it is. And then all you're going to do is hook your water lines back up. Just screw them in. Give them a little snug. You don't have to tighten them down like, you know, they're, but you don't want them to leak. And then make sure that you, when you put your pan back in, make sure that you hook up your water drain lines. And that's it. That's pretty simple. It doesn't take a whole lot. All right, guys. One little warning I need to tell you about is these edges right here where your pan sits back in there or your sink part sits back in there are really sharp. So be real careful. And when you put your caulking back down, you don't have to go crazy with the caulking. You can just put a little bit down and just put it like in each corner like that, okay? And then a little small bead down the edge. That's all you need. And then You can take a weight like a book or a brick or something, put a rag over your sink so don't scratch it up, set that brick on there, leave it on there for about 24 hours, and then let the caulking dry. I use the silver caulking. You can buy it at Lowe's and everywhere else. Side note, guys, on this same thing, there's my brick. I already put my sink back in. I caulked it. And if you notice, I got caulking seeping out on the sides right there. All you got to do is let it dry, then take a razor and just cut around that. It'll peel right off. It doesn't take anything at all. But let it dry good before you do that, okay? And the other thing is connecting your sink lines. You may have to crawl underneath the cart or have one of your youngins do it and then just poke those lines in and make sure they're connected to the sink. You know, it's just easier. It's almost impossible to connect them from the top. I can't hit the hole. Anyway, guys, this is Doug's Dogs. I hope that helped some of you. Y'all have a good day.